Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is Bhupesh. So today we'll be talking we'll be taking a new topic actually about how to parse a YAML file. And why are we doing this topic? Because I've received a lot of requests about how to do, you know, YQ templating. Now, what is YQ templating? How to read a YAML file? Because nowadays in DevOps world, the configuration is parsed by YAML files only. So how to read YAML files using YQ and to make our life easy to do any kind of, you know, development or modifications using Python or non-Python. Okay. So just to quick recap what we have done, this in the same playlist. If you're not to subscribe my channel, please do that here so that you can get similar kind of videos from the channel itself. So what we have done so far, we have seen how to read and write YAML files using Python, how to, you know, insert data into MySQL database using Python. So now today we'll be talking about a simple quick installation of YQ binary onto Ubuntu box and onto the Windows box, and then we'll see quick example of how to read YAML files and how to create variables out of it so that it can be passed onto some other Azure pipeline or some other Kubernetes objects if needed. So yeah, there's a quick introduction. So basically we have three kind of data into YAML files. It can be a key value pairs, or it can be arrays, and it can be dictionaries. We'll see one by one. So key value pairs, nothing. Just left hand side is a key and the right hand side is a value. So you can see the pi value of pi is 3.14. The value of doe is a deer, a female deer. Okay. And then my first name, Bhupesh, last name is Sharma. So it's just a simple key value pairs in YAML file. Second kind of objects that you find in YAML is list or arrays. Now, as the name goes, arrays are the collection of similar objects. So you can see in the tables array, we have one table one array and table two array. Similarly, we have this calling birds array, which have four birds name. So this is nothing but an array structure in YAML file. And this is how we define it with the help of this, dash defines it as an array. Now, the third and final thing is, in YAML, there's dictionaries and maps. Dictionaries and maps are simple, you can say, a collection of key value pairs, within one dictionary, within one variable, or you can say a map. So you can say, Xmas 50 is a map which contains three key value pairs and another dictionary, which is nothing but partridges, and having two key value pairs in this. So we can say this dictionary has certain key value pairs and another dictionary is in this. These are the primarily three things that we talk about into YAML file, and this story revolves around these three only. If you understand these three, then life would be easy to understand YAML file and do reading YAML files or parsing YAML files using YQ. Now we'll see a little bit, practical example so that you can understand it a better way. So this is a GitHub page that I've created for this YQ templating. We'll see quickly, what is all there in this page. We'll come onto the VS Code again. So first of all, we need to install this, YQ. It's simple binary written in Go. So you can, if you are working on Ubuntu box, you can simply run it using Brew. If you are not using Ubuntu box, you can install directly the binary. The binary from wget from this URL. Since I'm already having Brew, I'll just run this, and it will just install the YQ and it will add it to the path variable so that it is up and running. For me, it is already there, so I'm good. So I'll just do a YQ and then help. Right. Perfect. Now we'll see how to read the YAML files using this YQ. Now, if you're not using Ubuntu, but you want to install into Windows system, that is also easy. You need to either download this exe or download this zip file and add the exe path to a environment path variable. And how to add this env path variable, you can simply come here. I'm talking about the Windows environment variable. Click on path, edit, and then add new, new path here, and then simply click okay. That's it. Perfect. Now this is all about documentation. A lot of documentation happens. Quickly see the example. So this is my first YAML file. I'm just taking the same YAML file which is there into this playlist and to the same GitHub. So this is my first YAML file, and it has multiple things. Like it has a key value pairs, and it has a arrays and list, and it has a dictionary also. Let's see how it works. So I'll go to the I just open the box. So I'm into this. Okay, so I'll do YQ. And then this is the starting quotes. Let me first of all get the first name from this YAML file. So I'll do first name. And then first.yaml. First name is coming out to be null. Interesting. Why? Okay, I need to create a string. So let me run this command again. I think I was running into wrong file. So this is my YAML file. I'll just do a YQ first name. So I want to get the first name from this YAML for this key value pair. So this will I'll split on Bhupesh. And then suppose I want to get the list of this variable. So what I'll do YQ starting single quotes, and then I'll just do a calling words. Now I want to show one quick thing. Bertha. YQ calling bird. Okay. Oh, my bad. Okay. Yeah. Fine. So you can see these are the values that are returned by this command. Now I want to this is the array list. So what I want to get the actual value. So what I'll do, I'll just simply do this and I'll get the result. Now this is getting the result from a array list. Now let's see the example of this dictionary map. Okay. So I'll do YQ. And then I'll do this quick and then yeah. Now what I'm running, I'm just trying to get the details underneath this x5th day variable. This is a dictionary, a nested dictionary. Now suppose I want to get the value of this count. So what I'll do, I'll just do one more level. I'll come here. See, now I'm able to get the count and location. So if I do this location, appear tree. So suppose I want to fetch this variable and store it to a variable which need to be, using something else, suppose into my Azure pipeline or something. So I'll do something like this. And then I'll do echo where. Now I can use a variable which is being passed from a YAML file and then check it accordingly. So let's see another example, which is just nothing but the second .yaml. Suppose I want to see the database structure, entire data structure. So what I'll do, YQ database second.yaml. I can see the complete data structure details. Okay, now suppose I want to see the credentials of this database. So I'll come here again. I'll do credentials and then this. Okay. Similarly, I can get the different tables on this. So let me just run the tables. Now tables is a array, okay. Database and then tables. See, now this is coming out to be a array with two objects. So now let me just first of all get the value. So if I do something like, now let me show you one quick example. If I do something like this name, then it will give you an error because it is an array. It is saying cannot index array with name. So we need to index an array with the proper syntax. Okay, so what I'll do, the same thing, but first of all I'll say this is my array. Perfect. Now in this array, give me the name. Now you can see the name is coming properly. Again, if I go inside this, give me the columns. Column is again another array. Okay, array within an array. So I'll do one more thing. Array within array. Okay, now these are all values that are coming from these different columns. So this is how you need to communicate with YQ with the different YAML files, and you can have any kind of complex YAML files also. This is just an idea how to read YAML files using YQ. hope it was a little bit, you know, understandable. Yeah, it will take some time to get into your head, but yeah, if you understand it's a YAML parsing and there are a lot of complex things available, but first of all you need to understand how your YQ works and how can you parse a simple YAML and a complex YAML using different you know commands, and then you can do any of your work. Now in similar lines, if you want to get more details about YQ, you can do one more thing: YQ GitHub, or you simply type YQ. The first page that's coming to your screen is the official YQ open source project that is being developed by this person, Mike Para. And then you can see n number of examples also. But just to start with development, you can simply go ahead and check out this page and then do certain examples. So I'll just maybe I'll stop this video here. Please comment in the comment section if you want to understand more about YQ and what are the other challenges that you face when you work with YAML files parsing. And the same YQ can be worked with JSON files also. But for now, let's keep it simple with YAML files, because YAML files used everywhere, whether it is your pipeline, Kubernetes world, or anywhere. So give it a shot. Put comments in the section if you have any kind of doubts and queries. Do not forget to like and subscribe the channel for more similar kind of videos. So yeah, quick recap. Okay, what we did, we just simply ran a couple of examples using YQ. Yeah, so I would say let's stop it here. See you in the next video. Thank you. Bye bye.